10 safes installed to keep customers and employees safer inside 116 Walgreens stores across Oklahoma. Today marks day one. The company now keeps commonly stolen pills inside them. TUNA reporter Liz Bryan found this comes days after a holdup at the Owosso Walgreens.
Karen, the longer a robber has to wait to steal pills inside any Oklahoma Walgreens, now the longer he or she will be on video surveillance camera. And the theory is it's no longer worth the wait. Row after row of white bottles on white shelves. Yet the one stolen most.
So now it's activated.
Locked behind this white steel door with a warning. You must wait minutes for it to open.
I don't feel like anybody's going to be more violent. I don't feel like anybody's going to be more anxious or angry. When they're coming in, their idea is to obtain the medication quickly and leave quickly.
Pharmacy manager Olivia Ochoa dealt with the aftermath of a robbery at her Midtown Tulsa Walgreens this year. The bottles turned around because the company does not want you to know what's inside here. But we found here in Oklahoma the top three pills stolen, hydrocodone, oxycodone, and Xanax. Tulsa police say the drug of choice in this city stands alone, OxyContin.
I think it's an awesome idea, to tell you the truth. I mean, makes me feel safer. Because I think people aren't going to try to rob while this is going to happen to them. You know, that things are going to be detoured, things are going to be set back for them.
For Walgreens pharmacist, it ensures any pills they're dumping out go to those with a prescription.
We close the safe back up. If you choose to come to my Walgreens and decide to rob me, you are probably going to be caught.
Now, since December, we dug deeper and found that robbers have hit 36 pharmacies here in Tulsa. That's more than the last 3 years combined, which there's about 6 robberies a year in the last 3 years here in Tulsa. Now, on Monday, a robber hit a Walgreens at Owosso. That's the second pharmacy robbery in that city this year. Live, Liz Bryant, 2 News, works for you.
Hi, Liz. Thanks. 2 News going in depth tonight. State narcotics experts blame addiction for the uptick. People get hooked, a doctor cuts them off, and desperate times call for desperate measures.
And they come from all walks of life. They're not always street recreational users with an addiction. They come from people who have college degrees on the wall and running businesses, but because of an accident, they got put on pain pills.
There's also a demand for the pills on the street. They go from anywhere from $2 all the way up to $20. For just one pill.